welcome everyone to today's edition of McCall's Science Enrichment. And today's experiment is called Lego Hoberman Sphere. Now that's a mouthful. And I'm going to begin with the Lego portion of today's experiment, and then we'll get on to what Hoberman spheres are using Legos as building supplies. So the four items that you see here in front of you are for the most part identical. There is some differences in color, but for the most part, they're the same shape, the same size, and they are the beginning building blocks for creating your very own Lego Hoberman sphere. You'll need a lot of these, and it depends on this little middle piece here that will determine how many of these you need to build a Lego Hoberman sphere. And the reason why this middle piece is so important is because if we just focus on this middle piece here, each of these little pieces that we need to make a complete Lego Hoberman sphere has an angled middle section, and then it has sort of a straight piece here, and then we have a little end piece that has a hole on the end. Now the end piece doesn't change. You have one of these on each end, and that's fine. So we can connect that back up. Now the straight piece is a straight piece. If you want to build a bigger Hoberman sphere, all you need to do is take another straight piece and attach it, put in another red attachment there, and there you go. You can create this each arm to be as long as possible, but you have to have the same length here as you do here. But the longer the arm, the bigger the Hoberman sphere that you end up with. Now it's the middle piece that's the important thing, because the middle piece has an angle to it. Now you notice this little middle piece here is not straight. It doesn't look like this piece here. No, there's an angle to it. And that angle can change based on the Lego piece that you choose. So this angle piece here has a wider or broader angle than this one does. This is also available in Lego sets. This angle has a smaller angle than this one does. This one's wider and this one is more narrow. You can use either one of these to build your Hoberman sphere, and it'll give you basically a different design. Now, this one is a little broader, let's say, than this piece. You can also use this angle connector to build your Hoberman sphere. So we have a broad angle, we have a little less broad angle, and we have a little more narrow angle. Now, the only angle connector that you cannot use that's available with Legos is this one. This one is a 90-degree connector, and it will not work. You really can't use this to build a Hoberman sphere because the angle is simply too small. You need to use something that is a little wider like this, this, or this to build your Hoberman sphere, and hopefully I'll be able to show you those here a little later in the video. So when you start with the angle connector, here are your three choices when it comes to Legos. Now, this is the Lego end. Let's now talk about the Hoberman end. Here we go. So to understand what a Hoberman sphere is, we use one of the basic elements of that sphere called the Hoberman circle. Now, these circles start out looking something like this. Okay, that is a Hoberman circle, believe it or not. And depending upon the angle connectors that you choose, if you're using a wider angle, you'll end up with, oh, something like, I'm gonna guess, maybe four of these circles. Some Hoberman spheres that we'll see in today's video use six Hoberman circles. Now, a Hoberman circle is very simple. A Hoberman circle takes linear motion and changes that linear motion to radial motion. And those words can be very, very simple. Linear motion simply means a line. So if we have sort of like a steering wheel here, a circle, and we have a line that cuts that circle directly in half, let's say that that line is now horizontal. It's going left and right. That's our line. So that linear direction here, if I take our little Hoberman circle and place it on that line just like that, you'll notice that if this is a steering wheel shape here, and I take my fingers and put them on the steering wheel like we would be driving a car, then this would be 9 o'clock, and this would be 3 o'clock. If I simply take my fingers and put them at the 9 o'clock and 3 o'clock positions, you'll notice that my fingers are exactly where that line cuts the circle in half, okay? Now, the center of our Hoberman circle is at the center of our circle here, okay? Now, if I take my hands and I move this circle out this way along that line, or back in this way along that line, I'm using linear motion. I'm moving these points of our Hoberman circle out along a line or in along a line. And the thing about a Hoberman sphere is it will change shape as I move my fingers along this line. Now watch what happens. I'm gonna take and use linear motion, and that linear motion is gonna change the shape of this Hoberman sphere to a circle. Now watch, as I move my fingers out along that line, watch what happens to our Hoberman circle. And it can even go a little further here. Let me just keep moving it along that line. And there, okay? We started out with something that looks like a flower, but now we have something that's much more like a circle. Now, I can also move along that line this way now. If I take my fingers here and move these pieces inward towards the middle, again, I'm moving along this line right here. I change it back to the shape of a flower. And this Hoberman circle is the building block of our Hoberman sphere. Now, you know that a circle has two dimensions. It has length and it has width. For us to create a sphere using this circle, I have to have length, width, and depth. So you need at least two of these to make a Hoberman sphere. And in some cases, four or six. So again, I'm taking linear, and as I move along a line, this becomes more of a circle. Now that line can be this way as well. I can take my fingers and move along the line here, and we're back to our beginning point. Now, I said that a Hoberman circle and a Hoberman sphere changes linear motion to radial motion. Radial simply means that this line is going through the center of the circle. Now, if I had a whole bunch of lines here, cutting that circle in half, going in all directions, these lines would look like a wheel. And that's precisely what this is. It's a wheel of sorts. I'm simply using linear motion to change our circle to a true circle shape, and there we go. So let's take a look at some of these Hoberman spheres that we have. Hang on. The inventor of the Hoberman circle and the Hoberman sphere was a mechanical engineer named Chuck Hoberman. And Chuck Hoberman was first inspired by the science behind the folding of origami art on paper. And he was looking for a way to design a mechanism that could be created on a larger and larger scale that would begin as a very small, very precisely folded object like this, and have the ability by using linear motion. Now I'm going to move my two hands apart here along a horizontal line. And as I move my hands along a horizontal line, that object has now become very large. So I have here a sphere. I have a sphere that's made up of two circles that are joined together. And when I push my hands together again towards each other, that large sphere becomes very small. Chuck Hoberman had visions of this invention here being used for medicine, and in fact it has. Many of these Hoberman designs have been used to create very, very small tools that can be folded up into a small space like this, and then used to enter the human body during surgery, and then with the tug of some linear motion there, that small tool can be used to expand and help doctors and physicians and surgeons when they're performing internal medicine on the human body. These shapes have also been considered by NASA, because here you can take a very small, very precisely made object and make it much, much larger in space to harvest solar energy, or to set up a solar sail, or anything you want to do. Now, here on Earth, Hoberman spheres have been produced and packaged as toys. They have been used as openings and doorways for the Olympics. They have been installed in museums, and they're really, really fascinating. Now, I mentioned earlier that the designs here for this Lego Hoberman sphere uses Hoberman circles, and it does. But there's one catch. You'll see on the enclosed building instructions that each of these circles is a half circle, and each half circle is joined at this little junction box right here. So the original Hoberman circle that I showed you didn't show the junction box, but this does. So for this Hoberman sphere, we have one half circle, two half circles, three half circles, four half circles, five half circles, six half circles. This Hoberman sphere uses six half circles. You'll see some more Hoberman spheres here in a bit that use four half circles using these junction boxes. Now, the two words I want to leave you with today as we finish out our video is the word expand. That means to go from a small shape to a large shape, expand. So we've gone to the large, that's expand. Now the opposite of expand is contract. I'm going to go from a large shape to a small shape. Here is contract. So there we go. One more time, we have expand to become larger and contract to become smaller. Now here is a quick little video showing each of four different Lego Hoberman sphere designs expanding and contracting. Thank you for watching. We'll see you soon. Take care. Bye-bye.